really going to show you what we've done with docking here, but docking is really one of the main features that we're adding in our next version 5.5 of trade ideas. So let me kind of bring up, let's say, the EV related channel. And you'll see it's bringing everything into a container, a docked environment that allows me to manipulate it both based on size right here, where everything will adjust accordingly. And then I could take it and I can move the whole group of windows over to my other monitor. On my other monitor, I've got a whole nother dock set up where I've got this particular docked layout. So it's nice because you can have your normal workspace set up and bring in a docked channel bar, peruse it, take a look at what you want to look at, but you're not really going to kill your existing layout or do anything in a bad way to it. So a lot of great things that you can do once it's in a docked window as far as being able to customize it and manipulate it. Let's say I didn't want to have this thing stacked over one another. I could take this and maybe bring them side by side. And it really all depends on, you know, the windows that you're looking at, the type of data that you want to see in the windows with the columns and the number of columns that you want to look at, but super flexible. And if you want to take something like this and bring it back into a tabbed mode, you can just drag it right into the center. It's where that cursor is, right in the center, let go. And I'm just going to have some tabs here up at the top. Up here, I'm going to open a new docked channel bar. There's one channel, right? And so what I can do a couple of things. If I wanted to take this one window, this one dock here and duplicate it, I could duplicate it so I'd have a carbon copy. But if I wanted to just open up another one, I could open up another new docked channel bar and I could go to a different channel, you know, and maybe size it more appropriately, maybe not have it quite as big. And then, you know, we also have the ability to throw your custom channels in here as well. So you can build your own custom dock. And you can do really anything with it. We've, you know, I've got another docked container over here that has a little bit of the AI window in it. It's got some of my other windows, some top lists that are looking at particular portfolio of stocks. And then I'll show you a little bit about Brokerage Plus, because that's another thing that we're fitting into the dock to make it really useful and really engaging, because right now we've got different tabs up at the top. But then you can take these different windows, and if you want to move them around into another panel or another tab, you know, you can do that. So I'll put this thing into another tab. So I've got a tab here down at the bottom, and maybe down at the bottom I don't want to have my my P&L graph or my order entry panel or you know, something like that. So you can get really customized with how you're looking at these different views. But I think we're really close. I think we're, I want to say, a week, you know, away from being able to put out a beta version onto our site to let you guys bang away with and get some initial feedback. You know, we're always creating new technology, new versions, new features and functions. And so, you know, as we put this out, we'll get feedback and we'll make some enhancements and modifications and, you know, move on to the next group of projects that we have within the software.